Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Narayanam Narayanam Namaskrityam.
Narayanam Namaskrityam.
Naram Chaiva Narottamam.
Naram Chaiva Narottamam.
Devim Sarasvatim Vyasam.
Devim Sarasvatim Vyasam.
Tato Jayat Mudiraye.
Tato Jayat Mudiraye.
Nashta Prayeshva Bhadreshu.
Nashta Prayeshva Bhadreshu.
Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya.
Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya.
Bhagavati Uttama Shloke.
Bhagavati Uttama Shloke.
Bhaktira Bhavati Naishtiki.
Bhaktira Bhavati Naishtiki.
Krishnaya Vasudevaya.
Krishnaya Vasudevaya.
Devaki Nandanaya cha.
Devaki Nandanaya cha.
Nanda Gopakumaraya.
Nanda Gopakumaraya.
Govindaya Namo Namaha.
Govindaya Namo Namaha.
So, since today the whole world is celebrating festival, they're welcoming New Year. So we are also going to celebrate today Nandotsava. We are also going to celebrate the festival.
Shri Shuka Uvacha.
Shri Shuka Uvacha.
Nandastva Atmajam. Nandastva Atmaja Utpanne.
Nandastva Atmaja Utpanne.
Jathalladho Mahamana.
Jathalladho Mahamana.
Ahuya Vipran Vedagyan.
Ahuya Vipran Vedagyan.
Snata Suchira Lankruta.
Snata Suchira Lankruta.
Shri Shuka Uvacha.
Shri Shuka Uvacha.
Nandastva Atmajam Utpanne.
Nandastva Atmajam Utpanne.
Jathalladho Mahamana.
Jathalladho Mahamana.
Ahuya Vipran Vedakyan.
Ahuya Vipran Vedakyan.
Snata Suchira Lankruta.
Snata Suchira Lankruta.
Shri Shuka Uvacha.
Nandastva
Atmajam Utpanne.
Nandastva Atmajam Utpanne.
Jathalladho Mahamana.
Jathalladho Mahamana.
Ahuya Vipran Vedagyan.
Ahuya Vipran Vedagyan.
Snata Suchira Lankruta.
Snata Suchira Lankruta. Shri Shuka Uvacha.
Shri Shuka Uvacha.
Nandastva Atmaja Utpanne.
Nandastva Atmaja Utpanne.
Jathalladho Mahamanaha.
Jathalladho Mahamanaha.
Ahuya Vipran Vedagyan.
Ahuya Vipran Vedagyan.
Snata Suchir Alankritaha.
Snata Suchir Alankritaha. Shri Shuka Uvacha.
Shri Shuka Uvacha.
Nandastva Atmaja Utpanne.
Nandastva Atmaja Utpanne.
Jathalladho Mahamana.
Jathalladho Mahamana.
Ahuya Vipran Vedagyan.
Ahuya Vipran Vedagyan.
Snata Suchira Lankrita.
Snata Suchira Lankrita.
Shri Shuka Uvacha.
Shri Shuka Uvacha.
Nandastva Atmaja Utpanne.
Nandastva Atmaja Utpanne.
Jathalladho Mahamana.
Jathalladho Mahamana.
Ahuya Vipran Vedagyan.
Ahuya Vipran Vedagyan.
Snata Suchira Lankrita.
Snata Suchira Lankrita.
Mataji, Swastayanam jata karmat jata karmat jata karmadasya vai karayama svidhivat pitru devarchanam tatha. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace Sri Bhaktivedanta Swami Shri Prabhupada. Shukdev Goswami said, Nanda Maharaj was naturally very magnanimous, and when Lord Shri Krishna appeared as his son, he was overwhelmed by jubilation. Therefore, after bathing and purifying himself and dressing himself properly, he invited Brahmanas who knew how to recite Vedic mantras. After having these qualified Brahmanas recite auspicious Vedic hymns, he arranged to have the Vedic birth ceremony celebrated for his newborn child according to rules and regulations. And he also arranged for the worship of the demigods and forefathers. Perfect. Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur has discussed the significance of the words Nandastu. The word tu, he says, is not used to fulfill the sentence, because without tu the sentence is complete. Therefore, the word tu is used for a different purpose. Although Krishna appeared as the son of Devaki, Devaki and Vasudeva did not enjoy the Jata Karma, the festival of birth ceremony. Instead, this ceremony was enjoyed by Nanda Maharaj, as stated here, Nandastu Atmajam Utpanne Jata Lado Mahamana. When Nanda Maharaj met Vasudev, Vasudev could not disclose, "Your son Krishna is actually my son. You are his father in a different way, spiritually." Because of fear of Kamsa, Vasudev could not observe the festival for Krishna's birth. Nanda Maharaj, however, took full advantage of this opportunity. The Jata Karma ceremony can take place when the umbilical cord connecting the child and the placenta is cut. However, since Krishna was brought by Vasudev to the house of Nanda Maharaj, where was the chance for this to happen? In this regard, Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur desires to prove that with evidence from many Shastras that Krishna actually took birth as a son of Yashoda before the birth of Yogamaya, who is therefore described as a Lord's younger sister. Even though there may be doubts about the cutting of the umbilical cord, and even though it is possible that this was not done, when the Supreme Personality of Godhead appears, such events are regarded as factual. Krishna appeared as Varahadeva from the nostril of Brahma, and therefore Brahma is described as the father of Varahadeva. Also significant are the words Karyanam Asa Vidhivat. Being ordained with jubilation over the birth of his son, Nanda Maharaj did not see whether the cord was cut or not. Thus, he performed the ceremony very gorgeously. According to the opinions of some authorities, Krishna was actually born as a son of Yashoda. In any case, without regard for material understandings, we can accept that Nanda Maharaj's celebration for the ceremony of Krishna's birth was proper. This ceremony is therefore well known everywhere as Nandotsava. Om Agyana Timirandhasya Gyananjanam Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Jena Tasmai Sri Guruve Namaha Mukam Karoti Vachalam Pangum Langayate Girim Yat Kripatamaham Vande Sri Gurum Dinatarinam Paramanandhamadavam Nilachala Divasaya Nityaya Paramatmane Balabhadra Subhadraya Sri Jagannathaya Te Namaha Nityananda Maham Naumi Sarvananda Karamparam Harinama Pratam Devam Avaduta Shiromanim Ananda Lila Maya Vigrahaya Hemam Vadivya Chavisundaraya Tasmai Maha Premrasa Pradaya Chaitanya Chandraya Namo Namaste Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shivasadi Gaurav Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare So let us participate in the Nandotsava. Let us go to Vrindavan with our mind. Sri Shuka Uvacha Nandastva Atmaja Utpanne Jatal Lado Mahamana Ahuya Vipravan Vedagyan Snata Suchira Lankruta Vacha Itva Swastayanam Jata Karamat Jasyavai Karaya Masa Vidhivat Pitru Devarchanam Tatha Nanda Maharaj, when we had to understand the history before we could come to this point, Nandastva Atmaja Utpanne. This is the subject matter of the first verse, and it is very important verse. It reveals so many hidden things about Lord Krishna's pastimes of taking birth. It is a very important verse for Gaudiya Vaishnavas especially. Jatakarma ceremony is a ceremony which is performed when the umbilical cord between the child and the mother is being cut. That is a time when Jatakarma ceremony is being performed. Certainly there was no festival when Krishna was born in Mathura. Because of fear of Kamsa, there was no festival. Vasudev had to take his son Krishna and bring it to Gokul and replace it with Yogamaya. This is what we understand. In this regard, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur is giving a little different understanding. He is saying that with evidence, he is proving that Krishna actually took birth in two places. He not just took birth in Mathura, but he also took birth in Gokul as son of Mother Yashoda. So, Shukdev Goswami, here he is saying, Nandastva Atmaja Utpanna, he is seeing that Krishna is born to Nanda Maharaj. That's why he is saying Atmaja. Atmaja means his son. Otherwise, a person who is seeing that Krishna is born there, and Sukadeva Goswami has initially described that Vasudeva brought Krishna from Mathura to Gokul and he placed him there, replaced it with Yogamaya. So Sukadeva Goswami is seeing this. So he could have said that Vasudeva's son. It was Vasudeva's son and they were celebrating Vasudeva's son. He could have said that. But no. Here he is saying Nandastva Atmaja Utpanne. Nanda Maharaj's son. That means Yashoda has given birth to Krishna. When Harivamsa Puran, it says that in the 8th month of 8th tithi, before the pregnancy was complete, Devaki and Yashoda, they both gave birth at the same time. Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur is saying that in the chapter 10th,
in the chapter canto 10 chapter 4 verse number 9 Maya Devi is been mentioned as Krishna's younger sister because she was born to Yashoda after him. Because that's why it is said that she is the younger sister of Krishna. Then in 14th chapter verse number 1 Brahma says that Krishna was born from the limb of Yashoda. Then again in 8th chapter 34th verse Garga Muni says that Nanda Maharaj had previously Nanda Maharaj's son Krishna was previously born to Vasudeva also. This is his saying this. So these are the evidences which Vishwanath Chakra Thakur is providing us to understand that Krishna was actually born there as well. Then we find that there are names of Krishna like Yashoda Nandan and Devaki Nandan. Yashoda Nandan, Nanda Nandan Krishna. There are names of Krishna. Like they have Devaki Nandan Krishna, Vasudeva Nandan Krishna. Similarly in Vrindavan, the names are Yashoda Nandan, Nanda Nandan. So these names are not just out of love or that was Nanda Maharaj and Yashoda, they believed that Krishna was their son. No, it was not the case. It was a fact that Krishna was born to Nanda Maharaj. And Vishwanath Chakra Thakur also said that he did cut the umbilical cord of the son and the mother. So Nanda Maharaj was very happy that Krishna appeared as his son, and he was very jubilant. Therefore, after bathing nicely, wearing very nice clothes, he decided that he will have a grand festival for the birth of his son. So he invited some brahmanas. It is a custom that when a son is born, the sadhus are invited to the house so that they can give blessings to the newborn. So after having this qualified brahmanas recite the auspicious wedding hymns, then he celebrated the birthday of the child. He knew some rules and regulations, so he decided to celebrate a festival, and along with that he also decided to worship the demigods and the forefathers. Here you can see that Nanda Maharaj himself is offering prayers, or is worshipping demigods and forefathers. So he is seeking blessings from them. It is not that we should neglect to offer pranams to demigods. They are devotees of the Lord. So certainly there are no demigod temples, but if you come across them, we should offer them respects and we should seek their blessings. Krishna conscious life. Nanda Maharaj gave 2 million cows to the Brahmanas. He divided. And one might say, how can one give 2 million cows? Is it practical to give? The whole day will pass by just giving. It is to be understood that Nanda Maharaj had 9 lakh cows. And it is not that they were staying in Nanda Maharaj's courtyard. No, they were all scattered in Brajsunder. So for example, if Nanda Maharaj have to give some amount of cows to a certain Brahmana, then he would say that the cows in this area are this much in number and they belong to you. I donate that to you. So you take care of that. This was the way of giving or donating the cows. So, Nanda Maharaj gave 2 million cows which were completely decorated with cloth and nice cloth they were decorated, and he also gave them, the Brahmanas, jewels in charity. He gave them ornaments. He gave them 7 hills of grains. Still in villages, there the grains are brought together and to preserve them, they are formed like a hill. They are made in the form of a hill and they are preserved. So, Nanda Maharaj gave seven hills of grains, and he also gave them cloth which had golden embroidery. So now Shukdev Goswami is saying that what is the purpose of Nanda Maharaj giving all these things to the Brahmanas? What was the reason? Shukdev Goswami is saying it was for the purification. By passing of time, the land is purified. Like it becomes, land becomes contaminated for some reason, but as the time passes, it becomes purified. By bathing, the body is purified. By purification ceremonies, the birth is purified. When all these ceremonies are performed for the baby, the baby is blessed. And by austerity, senses are purified. That's why we are recommended to perform fast for Ekadashis. Ekadashi is the only tapasya. Ekadashis and fasting for Janmashtami, Ram Navami, these are the festivals for which we fast, and the fasting has to be done nicely. It is not that on Ekadashi day we have a different variety of feast, that is Ekadashi. No. An Ekadashi means if you don't have a physical service like book distribution or some important services which takes out your physical strength, then it is advisable that the devotees fast with water or without water, Ekadashis. So this will such kind of austerity, it purifies one's senses, purifies one's mind. By worship and charity, by worshipping Brahmanas and giving charity to them, the wealth is purified. Certainly when the grahasthas, when they are earning outside, there is some kind of contamination is there in the wealth. Contamination means a chance wherein the money is being used for sense gratification. If it is used for sense gratification, then the money gets contaminated and we will have to suffer for that. So, but if we offer that money in the service of the Lord, in the service of the Vaishnavas, in charity, then the money gets purified. By satisfaction, mind is purified. Satisfaction is the most important thing. If our mind is not satisfied with what we have, then we will keep on hankering. We will keep on desiring things, and then we will have to suffer. But if a devotee, if he is only depending on the Lord, and if he has faith that whatever Krishna is giving, Krishna is maintaining me, Krishna is protecting me. So he has faith that Krishna is my protector and he is my mentor and he will take care of me. There is nothing to worry. He is satisfied by keeping faith in the Lord. So, by satisfaction, the mind is purified. And by self-realization, the soul is purified. Just like food is very essential for body. Food. Why? For nourishment of the body. If there is no food, then how will we can keep this body and soul together? So for nourishment of the body, food is required. Similarly, for Srimad Bhagavatam or Krishna Katha is required for the satisfaction of the soul. I would like to give one more example. For suppose, if we become sick. So if we are sick or if we are healthy, in either cases, food is required. When we are unhealthy, we might take food, we might take medicines. But in unhealthy situation also, we take food. And in healthy situation, we don't take medicines, but we take food. So in either situation, food is required. Similarly, Srimad Bhagavatam or Krishna Katha is very much important it is a food for the soul. We are healthy or unhealthy, Srimad Bhagavatam is a food. Just like food is nourishment for the body, Srimad Bhagavatam gives nourishment to the soul. And when we take shelter of Srimad Bhagavatam, then we become self-realized. What? Why? How Srimad Bhagavatam helps in self-realization? Because By the culture of this knowledge, Srimad Bhagavate Mahamuni Krute Kimva Parareshwara Sadhyo Radaya Varudri Atra Kruti Bhi Sushru Bhisakshanath. By the culture of this knowledge, when one desires to hear Srimad Bhagavatam, Lord, the Supreme Lord Shri Krishna is agreed to get bound up by that devotee in his heart. So by the culture of this knowledge, the Supreme Lord is established within the heart. So Srila Prabhupada is saying that these are the Shastric injunctions concerning how one can purify everything and still enjoy a material life. Even 5,000 years ago, Nanda Maharaj and the other village, this village people, they knew very well how to purify their existence. But today, people, they call themselves very advanced in material civilization, but they don't know how to purify themselves. Saumangalya Giro Vipra Suta Magata Vandina Gayakascha Gajurne Dur Bhairyo Dundubye Muhu. Now Nanda Maharaj requested his Brahmanas to recite Vedic hymns. And by their chanting of this Vedic mantras, the whole atmosphere was purified. And then, Suta, Magad and Mandi, there are three are mentioned. Sutas, they were professional in reciting the old histories. The Magadas, they used to sing the old histories of royal dynasties. And Vandis, they used to sing prayers according to the situation. So earlier days, when there was a festival or a party, it was not that they used to have discos and everybody used to dance naked. No. It was not like that. This, in Vedic culture, the Brahmanas, they used to invite Brahmanas, they used to invite these Sutas, Magadas, Mandijans, and they used to hear about the old histories from the Puranas, from the old histories of how they performed devotional service in the past. So many kings, or just like Yayati Maharaj. Yayati Maharaj was engaged in ruling the kingdom. And when he heard about the glories of Amrish Maharaj, he got detached from his kingdom and everything. How Amrish Maharaj used to perform devotional service. So when Yayati Maharaj heard about the glories of Amrish Maharaj, it helped him to develop a detachment from his sense gratification activities, sense enjoyment. And he decided that he will also practice Krishna consciousness like Amrish Maharaj. So hearing such stories, hearing this historical facts from the Puranas and the stories from the royal families, it encourages people to become God conscious. So that was the purpose. In Brajmandal, the Brajmandal was fully decorated with varieties of festoons and flags. In different places, the gates, which were made with varieties of flower garlands, pieces of cloth and mango leaves. So many places in the Brajmandal, they made gates. In India also today, when there are festivals like Ganesh Utsava or Ganesh festivals is very popular in India. So they make this such kind of arrangement. Everywhere you will see, today also, that they make big gates and decorate that with flower and beautiful lighting is there. The courtyards and the roads and the houses of the people were very nicely cleaned and washed with water. So everything was clean and clear. The cows, the bulls and the calves were smeared with a mixture of turmeric and oil. They were decorated nicely. The body was decorated nicely and with various varieties of minerals. I mean the turmeric oil and some minerals, they decorated the body of the cow, bulls and the calves. Their heads were decorated with peacock feathers. and they were garlanded and covered with cloth and golden ornaments. Here our situation is that we don't have ornaments to wear for ourselves. And that time, in the time of Nanda Maharaj, they had lakhs and lakhs of cows, and all the cows, all the calves, all the bulls were decorated nicely with golden cloth and golden ornaments. Nanda Maharaj belonged to Vaishya community. Vaishya is agriculturist. We can hardly imagine how the cows were taken care by him. The cows were so happy. If they are taken care of like this, then they are very pleased. The cows are very pleased. It is said that during the time of Maharaj Yudhishthir, when the cows were pleased, they used to muddy the pasturing ground with their milk. So this was the glories of the cows when they are happy. There is peace in the society, there is joyful atmosphere in the society when the cows are pleased. Shukadeva Goswami is saying to Maharaj Parikshit, "O Maharaj Parikshit, the cowherd men were dressed very opulently with variable ornaments with garments such as coats and turbans. These are cowherd people, but they had such opulent dresses and turbans and everything. And decorated in this way, they were carrying some gifts to Nanda Maharaj. Because it was a festival time. and in the house of Nanda Maharaj, so everybody was carrying some gifts for Nanda Maharaj. Nanda Maharaj and Yashoda and for baby Krishna. Srila Prabhupada is making a point. Let's see the difference. That this cowherd community, this cowherd man were simply depending on two things. Agriculture and cow. And they were so opulent. But nowadays we are neglecting cow and we are killing the cows and we are neglecting agriculture. So our situation is that we are poor. The farmers are very poor. If you compare the farmers in the past and now the farmers, they don't have proper clothes also to wear. But in those days, Srila Prabhupada is mentioning that they were very opulent because they are only depending on agriculture and cows. Then Shukadeva Goswami is describing about the gopis. The gopis' wives, the gopis which are the wives of the cowherd men, they were dressed very nicely, very opulently, and with various ornaments, and they were applying kajal, ointment for their eyes. And their lotus-like faces looked so beautiful. And they had applied saffron and kumkum on their forehead. It is a Vedic culture that the married woman, they apply kumkuma. It kumkuma, and they also have their Mangal Sutra and so many other auspicious ornaments. The wives of the cowherd men were also hurrying to greet Yashoda, because they are very happy that their Sakhi Yashoda, they have given birth after a long time to baby Krishna, to the baby boy. Shukadeva Goswami is saying that because of natural beauty, the wives of the cowherd men, they had full hips and full breasts, which moved as they hurried along. Srila Prabhupada is saying that because of artificial living, women, they have lost their beauty. And although they claim to be independent and advanced in material civilization, still their beauty cannot be compared to the beauty which was there in the past. Now they have lost their beauty completely. Earlier, the people in the villages, they had a natural life. So and the woman, they developed a natural feminine beauty. But this was not the situation here. The women were carrying gold coins. Now what kind of, these are cowherd women, and what are they carrying for Yashoda? Gold coins, jeweled necklaces, nice clothes, newly grown grass, sandalwood pulp, flower garlands and similar offering on the plate of gold. And their women were very happy to because they are participating in a festival of someone else. Here in current situation is that we don't know who is our neighbor. We don't know who is what does he do, what where does he live, where does he work. We hardly don't know. But in Vedic civilization, the whole village was like a family, and they used to participate in each other's festival as if their own. They used to be happy to see the others happy. Here Yashoda gave birth to a baby boy, but everyone was celebrating as if the boy was born in their own family. This is Vedic culture. This is how a devotee should stay with each other, participating in the happiness of others and participating in the distress of others. We should be happy by seeing others' happiness, and we should be distressed by seeing others' distress. If you cannot do anything in their distress, at least feel some kind of sadness should be there in our heart. It is not that somebody is in trouble and we inside our heart is saying, he got the treatment. He got perfectly what was needed. Krishna punished him. So such kind of attitude, such kind of behavior is not appreciable. Now Sukadeva Goswami is still describing that the ears of the gopis were brilliantly polished. They were wearing brilliantly polished jeweled earrings, and from the necks hung the metal lockets. Their hands were decorated with bangles, and their dresses were of varied colors. And when they were walking on the road, from their hair fell the flowers used to fall on the ground. And so it was like the whole road was covered with flowers. So because so many ladies were walking, and in their hurrings, they were walking so fast, and so all the flowers used to fall on the ground. So while going, this is the description of gopis who were going to Nanda Maharaj's house to welcome Krishna, who was not. So these women are not ordinary. These are very special. These are associates of the Lord. They are expansions of Krishna's pleasure potency. Now they are offering blessings to Krishna. After they reach there, seeing Krishna, Lord Krishna, all of them, they started giving their blessings, saying that may you become the king of Braja and you all maintain the inhabitants of Vrindavan. They sprinkled a mixture of turmeric powder, oil and water on baby Krishna for auspiciousness, and they offered their prayers. So Krishna, who is birthless and who is the master of the whole universe, who is worshipped by Brahma, who is worshipped by Shiva and all the demigods, here in Vrindavan, that baby Krishna is being offered blessings by the coward woman. See the power of love. Will Lord Shiva or Brahma ever think of giving blessings to Krishna? No. Indra, can he think of giving blessings to Krishna? No. But here coward, simple woman, they are offering blessings that may you live long, may you become the king of Braja. He is the king of the whole universe. But they are saying, become the king of Braja and maintain all of us nicely in the future. So, in Vrindavan, Krishna is not the supreme personality of Godhead. Krishna is only the son of Nanda Maharaj. That's it. Outside in Dwarka or elsewhere, Brahma and all these people will come and worship him nicely. Indra will come and all other places. Indra came in Braj also. Brahma came in Braj also. But for them, Krishna is not God. Krishna, he lifts Govardhan hill in front of them. Krishna dances on the hoods of Kaliya. Or Krishna chastises Indra. Krishna will do all these things. But still, for these Brajavasis, Krishna is not God. For because Krishna, in his pastimes, he used to get scared by a cat. When there used to be a cat in the house, used to come, the Krishna used to go running like something very dangerous thing. He saw a tiger or something, and he used to run, used to hug his mother, "Mama, Mama, I saw something very dangerous." And the mama used to lift him and used to go and see what was that dangerous thing. That was a cat. When all these Brajavasis, they used to see on one side, when they used to see that Krishna is lifting Govardhan hill and Indra is coming and praying, and then Brahmaji is coming and praying. So they used to see, they used to get amazed, why all these people are coming to our Krishna? Our baby Krishna is... So for some time they used to think that might be Krishna, might be God or something like that. But when they used to see that Krishna is afraid of even cat, they just, oh no, Krishna is just an ordinary boy. He's just like one of us. He's not so special. So this is the mood of Vrindavan. Avadhyanta vichitrani vaditrani mahatsave Krishna Vishveshvare anante nandasya vrajamagate. Now, when all pervading unlimited Supreme Lord Krishna, the master of the entire cosmic manifestation, took birth in Nanda Maharaj's house, there was a festival in the whole universe at that time. And all these demigods, they resounded various musical instruments to express their joy. Nobody could see them, but the voices were heard by everyone. Especially in Gokul, everyone was hearing. There are so many musical instruments played very nicely, very beautifully. Very sweet melody was coming, but where it is coming from, nobody knew. But actually, Shukdeva Goswami is saying that the whole universe was celebrating the birth of Krishna. Krishna says, Yada yadai dharmasya gyanir bhavati bharata abhyutthanam dharmasya tadatmanam sujamayam. Whenever there is a declining religious principle, O descendant of Bharata, I come and establish religion. whenever Krishna comes in a day of Brahma, he comes in the house of Nanda Maharaj. And whenever he comes, that day, Janmashtami is celebrated everywhere. Now, in gladness, the cowherd men, they enjoyed a great festival of Krishna's birth by splashing one another's body with a mixture of yogurt, condensed milk, butter and water. They used to splash each other with yogurt. Buckets and buckets of yogurt was thrown on each other. And then butter was smeared on each other's face, like we play the festival of colors. So that was a festival of milk. So from this statement, we can understand that not only milk, yogurt and butter wasn't good amount at that time, it was so excess that it was used for throwing on each other. It was used as simple, like we use water. Similarly, milk was used like that. Here in US, here in the West, even the water is used carefully. But that time the milk and all those things were used for throwing on each other. Everyone had an ample stock of milk, and by using it, many varied milk preparations, people used to keep good health in natural ways to enjoy life. When they had pure milk in their life, pure for drinking, and they were not using the artificial butter coming in the packet, they are using pure butter. So their life was very healthy. They are fit and fine for enjoying. Nowadays we don't have proper health to enjoy. Even we want to enjoy this material world, then we cannot enjoy, because after little enjoyment we will fall sick. So now the great minded Nanda Maharaj, he gave clothing, ornaments and cows to this cowherd men also. He gave to Brahmanas, he gave to other people, but he also gave it to the cowherd men. Why? Understanding that they were devotees of the Lord. Then he also distributed charity to Sutas, those who came for singing the glories of the Puranas, the histories of the royal dynasties, and the Magadhas and the Bandis. He also gave them also charity, cow, and satisfied them as per qualification. He wanted that all these people that are coming to them should get proper gifts in return, so that they can bless my baby boy Krishna. When person has wealth, he should distribute this in the service of the humanity, in the service of the devotees. So by which the people they by their good wishes, the person becomes auspicious. Rohini cha mahabhaga nanda gopa vinandita vacharat divya vasasrak kantha bharana bhushita. Now Shukadeva Goswami is describing about Rohini. Rohini was another wife of Vasudev. The Vasudev was in jail. Kamsa had captured Vasudev and Dev kept in jail. So Rohini was here under the care of Nanda Maharaj, and she was very sad. Very, very sad. Even though it was a time of festival, but she was not so participating so much. Then Nanda Maharaj and Yashoda, when they were offering gifts to all the cowherd men and women, they also gave it to Rohini and requested her to decorate herself nicely and participate in the festival. So Rohini, she, on the occasion of Krishna Janmashtami, when there was a happiness, when Lord Krishna was born, the whole universe was happy, was jubilant. And all the living entities, they could feel a deep satisfaction in their heart, a kind of happiness in their heart, which they never experienced. So Rohini, even at the time of Krishna's birth, she forgot the pain that her husband is not with her, and she actively participated. So she decorated herself very gorgeously, and her service was to welcome the cowherd women who were coming to their houses, to Nanda's house. Her service was to welcome them, and her good fortune is that she became a mother for both Krishna and Balaram. She got opportunity in her life to serve Krishna and Balaram both. That's why she is called here as Rohini cha Mahabhaga. Mahabhaga means what a great fortune she had. When good fortune arises, then she, because of that good fortune, she could serve Krishna and Balaram both. Now Shukadeva Goswami, he describes something more. Tata arabhya nandasya vraja sarva samruddhiman havira nivasatma gunai rama kridam bhurnapa bhruna rupra. Now the home of Nanda Maharaj is eternally the abode of Supreme Lord and his transcendental qualities, and is endowed with all kinds of wealth. When Krishna is present at some place, and he has been here in the case of where Krishna is born there, so the wealth increased in Vrindavan. In entire Brajmandal, all of a sudden, there was an increase in wealth in all respects. That's why Nanda Maharaj was not knowing where is this wealth coming from. He was giving. But then this wealth was coming out because of Krishna's birth. Because the Supreme Lord is there, so the all the goddesses of fortune, they resided there. And because of that, the wealth increased. And Nanda Maharaj was happily giving to everyone. Brahma Samhita says, Lakshmi Sahasra Satasangrama Sevyamana. The abode of Krishna is always served by hundreds and thousands of goddesses of fortune. And who is the chief amongst them? Srimati Radharani. The chief amongst the goddesses of fortune is Srimati Radharani. Srila Prabhupada says this. I am not saying it. So, when all this wealth was increased in Vrindavan, there was a happiness on one side, but there was a fear on the other side. Fear was that if Kamsa finds out that there is so much wealth increased, he will find out the reason. What is the reason? And why is so much wealth? Why is everybody happy here? Because in Kamsa's kingdom, nobody was allowed to be happy also. And here everybody in Brajsunder was happy. So now Nanda Maharaj was, they had a meeting and they were thinking, what should we do? Because what should we do to, because they knew that every in entire Brajsunder the opulence was increased, the wealth was increased, the money and everything was in huge amount. So now they were thinking what to do. So let them discuss till tomorrow, and tomorrow we will see that Nanda Maharaj will go to Mathura to give taxes to Kamsa. And then that will be the appearance of, and when Nanda Maharaj goes there, Putana will come in Gokul. Okay? Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. So, anybody have any question? Any questions?
Just a little question. We celebrate Mangal Arti and Mangal Sweets, but then Mangalik in the astrology is bad. It's a bad thing, right? Is it two different words?
Yes.
Okay. They're not from Mars. Mangal is Mangal.
Thus, the Sanskrit, for one word, it has so many meanings. So, here Mangal means auspiciousness. And that is Mangalik. When there is...
It's a disturbance.
Yes, it disturbs auspiciousness. When something is wrong it disturbs auspiciousness. For devotees, there is nothing to worry. When you are practicing Krishna consciousness, when you are practicing Krishna, then all these grahas, all these planets, they become pacified by seeing that this person is practicing Krishna consciousness, practicing bhakti. So they don't trouble him. They offer their blessings to that devotee. Because if he is practicing Krishna consciousness and if the planets still trouble him, then they are doing Vaishnava Pratha. So the planets, the demigods and all these people, all these who are responsible for a person, for person's deed, they offer their blessings, they shower their blessings on him. So for devotees there is nothing to fear, Manglik or no Manglik. Only the devotees should see that they are engaged nicely in serving the Lord. In Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam. This is important. If you are not hearing about Krishna, hearing about the Lord, hearing Krishna Katha, hearing Srimad Bhagavatam, and you are not glorifying the Lord, His activities, you are not chanting, then the problems will come. But if you are chanting nicely, taking shelter of the Lord, serving Him with all your senses, all, then there won't be any problem. One, there is no need for one to be feared of all kind of grass. Because we will see in our discussion in regard to Putana Mataji, that wherever the glories of the holy name are being chanted, wherever the pastimes, activities of the Lord are being sung, at that place, all this planets and grahas and all this have no effect. We will see that. We have that. That is a point of discussion in our seminar also. Any other question? No questions? Okay. Grantraj Shunad Bhagavatam ki. Shri Prabhupada Ji Maharaj ki.
Brajsunder Prabhupada
Ji. Vacha Kalpataro Vashya Krabhasa Dabdeva Chapatitam Pavadeva Vashya Vaibhavana.